Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Nick here, and welcome to my review of Doctor Who Series 4, Episode 11, Turn Left. Woo! Turn Left. Okay. In this episode, whilst visiting a planet that, I'm not sure exactly what planet, but it's a very, I think it's Chinese-inspired planet, or that, or it's China in the far future, and we've got a few more suns or moons around the planet Earth. But anyway, Donna goes and sees this fortune teller, played by the actress who played Chantho in the last series, is episode 11, Utopia. And the fortune teller is part of the Trickster's Brigade. The Trickster, of course, being a villain from the Sarah Jane Adventures, appearing in the story The Temptation of Sarah Jane Smith in its first series. And sorry, that's the second series. Sorry, whatever happened to Sarah Jane Smith in the first series, then Temptation of Sarah Jane Smith in the second, and The Wedding of Sarah Jane Smith in the third. Also, fun fact, in Whatever Happened to Sarah Jane Smith, he did, or Whatever Happened to Sarah Jane, he queried what would happen, think of what would happen if the Doctor had never existed. So this episode, Turn Left, is basically that. It's basically the Trickster's wanderings, what he said to Sarah Jane, brought to life, this time through creating a parallel universe using this thing known as the Time Beetle, part of the Trickster's Brigade, to create a parallel world around Donna Noble, where the Doctor died during the events of The Runaway Bride, where she wasn't there. So he obviously found the Rachmos some other way and then stopped her, but died in the process, and Donna was uninvolved, and because of that, the Doctor was not there to stop the, was not there for when Jadoon took Royal Hope Hospital up to the moon, and he wasn't there to stop the Titanic crashing into Buckingham Palace, the Adipose, the Sontarans, and now the stars are going out, as a reference to what's coming in the next two episodes. On the plus side, there are no Master, so there's no Year That Never Was. Then again, the dystopian future following the Titanic disaster is not exactly much better to what it was after under the Master. So both these series have a good representation of what a dystopian future may look like, or a dystopian present slash past in this story's case. So as basically the premise of the story is, as I said, on an ordinary day, Donna Noble decided to go left, turn left, to go to work at HC Clements, which would lead her down the path to meeting up with the Doctor and then going to travel in time and space with him. On the other hand, if she turned right, she would have gotten another job somewhere else, and that decision would then have caused her not to meet the Doctor in The Runaway Bride, and therefore events have changed since Christmas, from Christmas 2007 to sometime in 2009. Things have changed significantly, and that's basically the story. But as we keep going through the story, we've got despite it going back to the Donna from Runaway Bride, sort of, character, as opposed to the Series 4 Donna, again, we get some great character development for her, as well as her family. Have I mentioned that I love Bernard Cribbins? And the three of them have to go through these events that keep changing the world around them, and everything from Christmas 2007 to sometime in 2009. First of all, with the Rachmos thing, where Donna's a witness to it, rather than actually being involved. She's in Chiswick, and therefore after that happens, with the Thames being drained, she's then fired from work because the business is losing money, so they let her go. And that's the time when the Royal Hope Hospital goes, and then with Royal Hope Hospital being taken, it's confirmed that Martha has also died whilst up on the moon, alongside Sarah Jane Smith, Luke Smith, Maria Jackson, and Clyde Langer, who were also, for some reason, at that hospital. Didn't see them in the actual episode, but I guess someone had to be there when the Doctor wasn't. This is also the first time in the show where Luke, Maria, and Clyde are mentioned by name. It's also the first episode to mention Gwen Cooper and Yanto Jones from Torchwood later on in the story. Luke, Maria, and Clyde are from the Sarah Jane Adventures. Later we get the Titanic disaster. Thankfully, Donna and her family are out of the city by then, because, as I mentioned in Voyage of the Damned, Turn Left actually downplays the disaster, because in that story, they were saying if the ship hit the Earth, it would destroy the entire planet, all 6 billion lives. In this story, it only hits London, it destroys London, and radiates most of the south of England. I think the only place on that map in the next scene that they showed that wasn't radiated in the south of England was Devon and Cornwall. and also South Wales was all right, but most of the south of England, by the looks of it, was irradiated, and London was definitely nuked. So this story actually downplays the Titanic disaster, because in that, in Voyage of the Damned, as I mentioned, both here and in that review, that if it hit the Earth, it would have destroyed the planet, whilst here it only destroys London and irradiates the south of England. So in comparison, we actually got off pretty lightly here. I mean, yeah, the whole of South England radiated and London destroyed. That is not good news, but compared to the whole planet being destroyed, well, at least we're not extinct. But because of that, Donna and her family have to move up north to Leeds, although she would have preferred Glasgow. And they're basically refugees. And then the Adipose incident happens in America this time, just as they were going to fund the UK as a relief, with a relief fund. And then Atmos goes ahead and pollutes the atmosphere, with Torchwood having to deal with that incident, with Captain Jack going to the Sontaran homeworld, and Gwen and Yanto are now dead. So basically, as we keep going through disaster after disaster, as I mentioned, the Master's not here because the Doctor, Martha and Jack didn't travel to year 1,000 trillion. They didn't meet Professor Yana. Therefore, Yana was still Yana, and the Master was still in his fob watch, and he never came to 21st century Earth and became Prime Minister, etc. So that's all erased. That's the only positive thing from this whole thing. Probably the Lazarus thing didn't happen without Saxon's involvement, the Master's involvement either, so that one's probably spared too. But now we're up to date, and we now come to leading into what's going to be happening in the next story with the Stolen Earth Journey's End, although Earth hasn't been stolen by them for the reality bomb. So maybe they choose another planet because Earth was so... wasn't in a good spot, or maybe it was some sort of a test. It must have been a test because Rose's power, though, Earth has been noticing the stars going out, etc. And yet they stopped the reality bomb in the next story. Spoiler alert. Oh yeah, speaking of Rose, she's in this episode after nearly two seasons after her last appearance, excluding the three cameos earlier this series. She's back. She's got a major role. She's the one who has to try and help Donna get out of this nightmare situation, and with the help of this parallel worlds unit, including Captain Magumbo, our universe's equivalent of Captain Magumbo will be in Planet of the Dead a few stories later down the line. Eventually, Donna is sent back in time to try and prevent herself from turning right so that she can turn left and sort everything out, eventually having to sacrifice herself to do so, but she manages to succeed in changing the universe. So Turn Left is a pretty heavy story. Lots of disaster, lots of dystopian future, and the whole stuff about England for the English as the new law. I wonder how Scotland and Wales feel, and Northern Ireland, come to think of it. And they can't kick out the non-English people, like the Italian people the family stay with, because the borders are closed. France, for instance, has closed its borders. So instead, the non-English people are sent to labour camps. But I think we're pretty much all aware what they actually mean. Wilf, in that moment, is just heartbroken, and Bernard Cribbins I just want to give him a hug. Ooh, that moment was... in fact, the whole story is quite pretty heavy, but that bit in particular... Yeah, it's a really good story that depicts the dystopian world, certainly after the Titanic stuff, really well, and does a really great job with our characters, both the main characters and the supporting characters. They're really likable and really enjoyable in the few scenes we get with them before they're taken away to the labor camps. It's also worth noting that throughout the story, people keep seeing something on Donna's back, which probably wouldn't have happened in the real parallel universe to what if there was a parallel universe like this. That hasn't been unnaturally made by the tricksters, but more the actual parallel universe. In that one, I don't think they would have had people saying there's something on your back, looking over on towards Donna's back. In this version, they do. It's also a nice time with Fires of Pompeii about the something is on her back, and also she's returning with Rose, was mentioned there. But yeah, this is a really good story. It's not a fun one. It won't be a fun. Well, maybe to start with, and then later down the line, it won't get fun. It will start getting very heavy. It gets a bit dark. It's still family friendly, but it's still pretty dark and pretty nasty. Apparently, this, along with Utopia Sound of Drums, Last of the Time, or specifically the latter two, are sort of backdoor pilots to Russell T Davies' Years and Years. This one's a good example of that, as would be Sound of Drums, Last of the Time Lords, or specifically Last of the Time Lords. I've yet to check that series out yet, so I'm not quite certain, but I've heard these this episode, along with Last of the Time Lords, are pretty much backdoor pilots to that series, with Sound of Drums also having some inspiration into it. As far as Doctor Who's concerned, this one is a very good depiction of what a universe without the Doctor would be like and how disastrous everything could be, especially for characters like Donna, Martha, Sarah Jane and Jack. It could be a bit of a disaster. And so this does a really great job. The final bit at the end, when the Doctor and Donna are talking, and then when Donna tells him what Rosa told her, the words bad wolf, and then everything turns into bad wolf. That's a pretty cool bit. Although how the TARDIS has bad wolf on it and the room's red for some reason, I'm not sure. Not quite sure. I guess just saying the words bad wolf just means everything is now saying bad wolf for some reason. Unless Rose was able to manipulate the words throughout time and space again. But yeah, this obviously means the end of the universe, whatever that may be. We'll find out next time in The Stolen Earth and Journey's End. Until then, Turn Left is a brilliant episode that, as I said, it depicts the worst of what could potentially happen without the Doctor's involvement, apart from the Master stuff, because he wouldn't be around. But besides that, and maybe Lazarus, there isn't really much positives going around. But to be honest, it could also have been a whole lot worse if Titanic had wiped out the entire planet. Could have been worse. Could have been a lot worse. Overall, I'm going to give Turn Left a 10 out of 10. Really great story and a great character piece for our main characters, with some amazing performances. Probably Catherine Tate's best performance of the series, possibly this or Journey's End, maybe. Bernard Cribbins is outstanding. Jacqueline King also gets a lot more to do in this story, and she's great. I mean, she had quite a bit to do in Partners in Crime and the Sontaran two-parter as well. Not so much plot-related, but quite a bit of stuff to do. But she's really great here. She gets some brilliant moments. And yeah, it's just a really great story. Also, Billy Piper is also really good as Rose again in this story. They were really good trying to save the universe, trying to get things back on track, etc. So with that said, Turn Left, brilliant. And now the thrilling conclusion to Doctor Who Series 4. Next time, The Stolen Earth and Journey's End. Join me tomorrow for that. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye. Don't forget to click below to subscribe to the official Nicholas Payne Retro YouTube channel. And the three of them have to go through all of these events. Hang on. It's also worth noting, as I said, the Doctor died around the Arachnos event, Runaway Bride. And then with the Royal Hope Hospital going to the Scar, being taken. Luke, Clyde, and Ron. Not Ronnie. Not Luke, Clyde, and Maria are from Sarah J. Luke, Maria, and Clyde are from this. So, in comparison, it's actually better. And then Atmos take attacks. And then the Atmos system. Therefore, Yana is still the master is still trapped. Speaking of Rose, she's in this. Who the R universe is equivalent to will be in Planet of the Dead. R universe is equivalent will be in Planet of the Dead, by the way. So, nice to get introduced to her, and eventually Donna and succeed in. I think we can pretty much all of, but we've, that's not been forced to be made unnaturally. But yeah, especially for main characters like Donna, or for characters. Until then, Turn Left is a great episode, a really, really great episode. And yeah, it's like I said, it's a really great story. And Billy Pipe also does a great job returning as Rose properly this time, and pretty much actually making me like the character. And I actually thought this character. And I thought she was really good here, to be honest. The character and Billy Piper. And now, we are... Next time, The Stolen Earth and Journey's End. Jill, join me next... Join me tomorrow for... Join me... Join me... Join me for... Join me tomorrow.